This is R.K. Mohanty. I'm from Lalit Kala Academy, New Delhi. And today is basically the paper or the areas is the Raughat of Odisha. It was a project we started in 2005. And this is a national project. We are doing it all over India. This is a part of this, our project work. And if I start this project, it will take much more time. I'm just giving you some brief experience and subject of this Raughat of Odisha, very nutshell, so that you can understand the basic concept of Odishan Raughat. And the Odishan Raughat, 1993, when K.P. Jaiswal discovered this Vikramkul Raughat site, then Odisha map, Raughat map came to the Indian Raughat of India. Then after that, you can go next slide, please. Then after that, 1950 and 1976, Rajguru and J.P. Singh reported two Raughat sites in Kalahandi, one is Gudahandi, and Jogimath in Nuapara districts. Then also in Sambalpur, I'm just giving just little brief idea. And then in Sambalpur district gazetteer, and that is also in Sundargarh, one Raughat site of Sundargarh. And Raughat site of Ulof in Jharsuguda districts, and Usakuti in Manikmada in Sundargarh districts. Then in 1975, Raknapathar in Jamra and Moirbhanj districts. Then in Nimar and Behra, they reported five Raughat site in Chengapahad area, in Sambalpur, Sundargarh districts. And in beginning of this 21st century, 2003, we started it, and exactly we started on the field in 2005. With the help of Sadashiv Pradhan, we covered 11 districts of Odisha, and near about we reported more than 100 sites in Odisha, 11 districts. And while doing this study or the fieldwork of the districts of Odisha, we found Sundargarh and Sambalpur, these two districts' concentration of Raughat is quite high. It is because of the geomorphological situations, the geological conditions. Next slide. Because it is very similar to the Bindhyan geomorphological situation. It's extension, you know, the Chotnagpur plate. And it is same climate of Madhya Pradesh is similar to, not same exactly. So Madhya Pradesh is the 70% of rock painting concentration in India. So that's why the Sambalpur and Sundargarh districts is comparatively much more higher than the other districts of Odisha. And then come to the next slide, please. Then Raughat in Odisha, basically we are known as two names. This is Lekhamada and another is Usakuti. Lekhamada means writing in Moda. Moda means, you know, shelter. Lekha means writing. The shelter having writing, it is known as Lekhamada. And Usakuti means worshipping. Usakuti, Kuti means, you know, chamber or hall. Usa means worshipping. Usakuti, two nomenclature, two name amari. But it's very peculiar to Odishan Raughat. Lekhamada and Usakuti is majorly known as in Odishan Raughat is concerned. Next slide. Local people identify one Usakuti or Lekhamada by identifying the hills or villages nearby to it. Such as Devrigad Usakuti, Ulup Usakuti, these are the villages or the hilllocks or the reserve forest. They are all related to these Raughat sites, and Raughat sites are identified or named according to the villages or the forest range or the hillocks. Often the Raughat sites are associated with the, sometimes in the epic heroes like Pandava or the Pandava Bakra, you know, and also Ram Chajya, and also Bhima in the Bhima Mandali. They are also associated with very much two epic heroes or legends, these peoples. Next slide. I'm coming to the straightway to the subject before. Here I'm just giving some little idea about Raughat. Here I'm giving you a brief idea about Raughat, which is basically in Odisha is concerned, not the Khandagiri, not the Udayagiri, not the Dhauli. I'm talking about much before to Dhauli, Khandagiri, and Udayagiri. I'm talking about more than 15,000 years before Mesolithic, date of Mesolithic or Microlithic time. So at that time in Odisha, you see the more than 11 districts concentrations are there, And these are mostly in prehistoric, not historic, they are all the prehistoric rock art. And rock art basically in two forms. One is pictographs, even in the form of pictures, photographs, in the form of paintings. And another is petroglyphs. Petroglyphs is form of engravings, etchings, bruisings. These are the two forms of rock art, pictographs and the petroglyphs. Odisha is the one of these states of India where you find both petroglyphs and pictographs concentration almost in equally. My point is almost both are quite same. If you look after the entire Indian subcontinent, two areas concentrations are quite high in the engravings is concerned. One is Ladakh, Leh Ladakh, another is Karnataka and Bellary area. The rest of the areas concentration are pictographs, paintings. But Odisha is a very peculiar character. We found both concentration as quite almost similar. And the subject matter of this Odisha rock art is we find the floral patterns, animal figures, human figures, or also you find the hunting scene, geometric patterns. These are the subject matters plentifully found. And the paintings, the colors are red ochre, white ochre, and charcoal, black. These are the three mostly colors are used. But in Indian rock art is concerned, except Madhya Pradesh, some areas like nearby Bhopal and Arjajing areas, the rest of these areas is highly concentrations only on red ochre. And when you go to the south, extreme south, only white ochres are found in Tamil Nadu and some part of Karnataka. But here in the Odisha is concerned, we found three colors quite more, and also some cases green color, which is very rarest color found in Bimbetka. Here also one or two sites has been reported. And when you come to the point of Bikram Kol, I'm just giving you some pictures. Bikram Kol, just give that one. You see this honeycomb pattern. You see this white and red ochre. And this right one is your engravings, various animal figures and some geometric patterns. Second slide, please. Then you come to the Uluk, Jharsuguda, Ulupgad. I'm just giving you the first, this is Usakoti rock shelter. They are all Usakoti rock shelter. You see the patterns. You see the patterns if anybody can see these patterns. The jhoti patterns or palm patterns, you see, is a very beautiful pattern. If today, if you go to prepare it, this is a rock engravings, purely rock engravings. This is a beautiful hand paint. And this is Ulupgad hillocks. See the height of this. The next slide. I'm just telling you one slide here. It's wild boar in Ulupgad. You see the engravings. I will explain to you the next three images later on. Next slide. And see, this is the Bhima Mandali Usakoti. It is in Sambalpur. See some sort of natural formation, but there is a typical patterns. These patterns are not very frequently found in any other parts of the India. You see these patterns. These patterns are very typical patterns. If it is visible, some triangle shape, not exactly triangle, but these shapes are not very frequently found in other parts of the country. Next, this is Chhattagarh. This site was discovered by us. We found this site. It has some paintings and also triangle shape figures. But these triangle shape figures are used by the people living around there by using vermilion, and they worship this shelter also. Many shelters being worshipped by the people living around this shelter site. Next, this is a Debrigad Usakoti, and also it was discovered by us. And number of paintings. This shelter is only famous. This entire area, Debrigad Wildlife Sanctuary, found 4 and 5 rock shelters. There is not a single engravings there, only paintings. Only red ochre paintings are found there. There is you find peacock motifs, human figures, and lizard patterns. N numbers of figures are there. Some animals also are there. And next slide, please. Then Debrigad Usakoti. This is human figure. You see the patterns of human figure and some decorative motifs and palm patterns. Then go ahead. Then you come to the Lekhamada pattern. That was your Usakoti. Then you come to Lekhamada. And this is your Sundargarh. It's another highest concentration of this area. A typical formation, natural formation of the passage of hillocks you see. And then you see animals, barking deers will be there. You see this yellow ochre. You see this very, this is yellow ochre. And this is here is red.
inside is your Kolkata. These are not very frequent to other parts of the country, but this is very familiar in Odisha rock art is concerned. Next slide. This is the same, like Amara, you see the barking deers very clearly, and other deers, and gaur, and the design is very famous. This design is very famous. This is the saw pattern, double saw patterns. Sometimes single saw pattern, this sometimes double saw patterns. Cutting of the woods or something like this. This is a saw pattern motif. The next, you see the Lakhamada Ganga Kol Kanika Sundarga. This is animals are very clear. Red ochres is very deeply red ochre. Pigments are used and decorative motifs with saw patterns. And then next, you see the footprints. Footprints are not very rare in rock art is concerned. Handprints are very frequent, but footprints are very rarely found, and it is found in Odisha also. And you see another is tortoise, then geometric patterns or some decorative motifs. Then next is next. But what is the typical and the best characters of this rock art, Odishan rock art is concerned? I'm just giving you, this is the, it has both pictograph and petroglyphs, does both paintings and engravings. Paintings I had already shown to you, and engravings also I had already shown to you. And some of the rock shelters are exclusively with paintings and rare phenomena, and I had already shown to you Debrigarh forest, where only paintings are found, only paintings are found. And second is some rock shelters, and then it has one specific rock paintings known as painted engravings. This is not only in famous in India, this is worldwide famous. Just go back this looks like engraving, something like engraved, but this entire panels originally is not engraved. This entire panel was engraved, then again pigmented with colors. Odisha rock art is the exceptional known as engraved paintings. They first do it engraving, then they pour it with colors. So this is the best quality of the rock art of Odisha is concerned. And painted engravings. Anywhere in India, you won't find painted engravings in rock art of India is concerned. Slides, text, rather. Engravings are deep cut, just a minute, jahan pe bore tha, wahin pe chale ja. Uluf, uluf, aage, 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 aage. Aage, aage, aage. Nahi, aage, matlab jahan pe painting, upar. Jaldi, jaldi, upar. Engravings are deep cut, that is U cut or V cut. Aage jao, aage jao, jaldi. Aage, aage, aage. This is the wild boar of Uluf. This is very famous wild boar. And this is also a boar of recently we discovered, or recently we find it in Magalai. And this is the highest peak of 17,000 sea level MSL height. This is in Chilling Valley, Ladakh. And this is your Karnataka. You see the difference of engraving. This is bruising. And this is a plain etching. This is the deep cut of engraving. This is sandstone. This is granite. This is granite. This is quartet. Bruising some, they use some stone tools, having dotting, and they make it. So this is the best difference. You see the deep cut. How they cut it? There is a deep cut of the engravings, and these engravings are not at all found in anywhere of the India. Such a prominent deep cutting or engravings not well found in India in rock art is concerned. And it has already two only named culture.
tech specialism, two name and culture only Lekhamoda and Usagoti. Anywhere in Rawghat, you don't find any name like Lekhamoda and Usagoti is concerned. And I had already shown you these saw patterns. This is very rarest. Geometric patterns are various decorative motifs are plentifully found in Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, but not in these saw patterns motifs are never found. And footprints are also very rare. It is found in Odishan rock art. And rock paintings are found multicolors like red, white, yellow, black colors, frequent in Odisha is concerned. Paintings are deep red in color. That is red ochre is two colors, little bit light, little or much more deep. Here is deep red color. And geometric designs, I show you the geometric patterns. There is a sign of bulba. People call it is a fertility, symbol of fertility. These symbols are never found in any other part of this country of a geometric. It looks like a geometric pattern, but it is not exactly the geometric pattern. It looks very similar to the triangle, but it is not a triangle. It is sometimes symbolic of a feminine or symbolic of a fertility cult. And most of the sites are associated with local legends that I already explained to you. And associations and concentration of rock paintings are found in the same. If you think about the rock paintings of India or rock paintings of Odisha, its presence are very clearly found in our tribal peoples in the house of Sohra village. You see the Sohra's paintings. Aap aage chale jao, dikhao. Haan, aage jao, niche niche jao. You see these Sohra and Varli. The figure of human figure, you see this figure of human figure, and also people, only people that use the human figure. Though the subject matter is different, but the figures, the painting figures are very clearly similar to the rock art of India is concerned and Odisha is concerned. Anywhere, everywhere, if you go to the Madhya Pradesh or other part of the country, a similar continuity of the figure you will find. So my point is, the rock art is not only concentrated on the rock shelters, it has come to the people's house, and nextly, it has come to the contemporary field. Even in Madhubani, next slide. In Madhubani, because I am working in Lalit Kala Academy, and in every year we are organizing more than 200 to 300 exhibitions there, and I saw the many paintings. And this similar continuity, you see the Aryan art. It's very similar, and now the contemporary art. I had already moved many villages. The similar paintings are found, but they are being used. It's a continuity of art. My point is the continuity of art, and similar art form are slowly, gradually developed, and it is still now in the contemporary field also. People use it. You see, this is the art of here. This is the banner, and this is used. And the same art is not only in the house of the tribal people. It comes from our ancestors and forefathers that they have left in the remote areas that not be accessible by many people. Very few people access this area, so that the common people are not very much known about these rock paintings. But still it is alive, and we need to protect these sites, because these sites, when it's exposed to the people, sometimes it's highly vandalized. And due to this, minings and all this development, many rock shelters are devastated in many sites that we know it very well. So it needs a very protection or proper care, and also extensive research also very much required in Odisha also. This is not the end of only the 11 districts. We need much more extensive study and research. Thank you very much.